Welcome, everybody, to What's Next? McKenzie Mitchell here with Alicia Taylor. And we are, a day and a half after New Year's Evil? And I just have to say, we're always on the same brain wavelength with our sparkles, what we wore on.
Wait a second, McKenzie. Should we sit like this?
It's kind of weird, huh?
Is this weird?
You're typically over
I'm
here.
I'm usually over there.
I don't have my box.
I need my box.
New Year's Evil. We were on the same brain wavelength as we were wearing sparkles and shimmer. Exactly.
Yeah.
And what about Dexter Lumis's tux, though? I didn't really expect him to pull out the tux for New Year's Evil, but
who knew Dexter Lumis was such a well-dressed man?
Yeah, who knew?
He looked sharp, almost not as scary as he usually is.
Oh, so you're not afraid of Dexter Lumis anymore?
Wait,
hold on. All of a sudden, you think that you're like best friends with Dexter because
I think I'm best friends with Dexter.
Yeah, last week you said that, you know, you kind of, he cued you in or he let you know a little bit that.
I just said you
He
were,
knew how to host the night because I said
you
I was
were
unsure.
Going to be surprised at his hosting skills.
Oh, that's not, as if you guys had talked to your friends. Do you text Dexter Lumis?
Don't hate, girl, don't hate. Let's talk about more about his outfit because okay. Our friend Josiah spoke with him about his fancy bow tie.
What did he have to say?
An outfit. Let's see what he had to say. Did he say anything?
The man is rocking a bow tie. Usually, I'm the guy who rocks the bow ties around here. I said, not today. I gotta give him his space to do his thing. He looks great in it. Dexter, how you feel about your bow tie today? Exactly.
That said it all.
Did he say anything?
Basically, he said, I don't know, Josiah said exactly?
He's my best friend.
So tell me what he said.
Dexter said he had a great time picking out that bow tie. He went to the men's fashion warehouse of Orlando and got himself a fancy suit.
Men's fashion warehouse of Orlando?
That's what he said.
So men's warehouse, not men's fashion warehouse?
No, this is an exclusive. Okay. The men's fashion Institute shopping district of Orlando.
That doesn't exist.
What did you think about Dexter's drawing us through the entire show? Because I thought that was amazing.
I thought it was great. I thought, you know, it's kind of what we expected because we're like, how else would Dexter talk? I thought maybe for a second Dexter would mutter like a word or something, but he didn't. He only just drew his whole way through. But I have to say, what?
I was gonna say, do you have a favorite drawing?
Yeah,
that's of this?
Actually same brain. Here we are, because I was about to say, my favorite drawing had to have been Last Woman Standing match, Rhea Ripley, Raquel Gonzalez.
Yes.
I mean, and talk about the drawing into an absolutely incredible match.
We knew that this was going to be a battle between the former best friends.
Yep.
Vic Joseph lost the commentary table during that match. I lost my chair. Rhea Ripley ended up with a pile of debris and tables and chairs on top of her.
It was chaos. They put it all on the line and they took it to an absolute limit. It was a brutal battle. But speaking of battles, let's talk about Finn Balor and Kyle O'Reilly for the NXT Championship.
You were backstage with the Undisputed Era during that,
right? I was, actually. I got to sit by Adam Cole. I had the pleasure of sitting by Adam Cole during the match.
What was that like? Did you guys have popcorn? What did you do?
You know, with every hit that Kyle would take, it was like Adam wasn't physically out in the arena, but it was like he was feeling all of those hits.
Well, that's his brother. Like, the Undisputed Era are brothers.
Truly.
And they, I mean, how can you sit back and watch your brother go through that kind of intensity in the ring?
It's family. It's a different kind of relationship. I can only imagine what they have and what they really have experienced together in Undisputed Era. So although Adam was very, you know, supportive of Kyle, I could still feel at the same time, he was like, oh man, why did you do this to yourself? You knew this was going to be a battle, and it sure was. At the end of the day, both of the men went to the hospital after NXT on Wednesday night, and then Finn Balor obviously walked away still NXT champion.
Finn Balor, though, came with those receipts.
He
you
did.
Know, Kyle O'Reilly broke Finn's jaw. Finn came with it.
Absolutely. And let's talk about what's happening next week.
Yes.
The Dusty Cup.
The Dusty Rose Classic, baby.
Yeah, we were talking about the Undisputed Era. They're facing off Roderick Strong, Adam Cole, against Brizango.
And then Grizzled Young Veterans against
Ever Rise. And I'm just going to go ahead and say this. I'm putting my money on Grizzled Young Veterans, because Ever Rise.
Oh, wait a minute. Ever Rise don't like you, right?
We've had a few encounters.
Had a problem.
They're always rude to me. I didn't talk trash. They're always rude to me.
Why are you shouting at me?
I'm just saying. They make me mad. that, okay? They make me angry because they're always rude to me. So, again, putting my money on grizzled young veterans.
Okay, grizzled young veterans. Well, do you know what I'm excited about? You and William Regal announced a little something special in the first ever Women's Dusty Cup Tournament.
So exciting. I want to know, who do you think would be one of the tag teams in this Dusty Cup Tournament?
Well, I'm sure we're going to see Kaden Carter, Casey Cat, and Zero.
Fair.
I would love to, I mean, you put your money on Grizzled Young Veterans. I would like to throw out a couple of dollars.
Okay, here we go.
Mercedes Martinez, is she going to find a partner and join the Dusty Cup? Maybe Dakota Kai and Mercedes Martinez?
Ooh.
I would love to see that kind of a pairing.
Okay.
If I can say so myself.
That'd be fun. That would be cool. Okay, I'm going, this is pretty obvious, but Candice LeRae and Hartwell, I think, will be a tag team in the Women's Dusty Cup.
No doubt.
I also was thinking about this. Shotzi Blackheart, Io Shirai. They've already been in the ring together in War Games, been on the same team. So I feel that
Io would come to the ring with a trash can.
I mean,
perhaps the trash can on top of Shotzi's tank.
That would be interesting to see, but hey, never say never in NXT, right?
We never say never.
Never say never. Cue the Justin Bieber music right here.
That wasn't for Justin Bieber. That was for Josiah.
Okay, well, it's been an exciting one. New Year's Eve was absolutely fantastic. It lived up to the hype, certainly. And next week is going to be no different when the first round of the Dusty Cup begins.
I cannot wait. You guys tune in next Wednesday and every Wednesday to live NXT action on the USA Network. McKenzie Mitch.
What's next?
Alicia, McKenzie, I'm what's next.